Right, Aki Kareem, British boxers. We're here at Salford City Boxing Academy today. It's always good fun coming down here. Good work being put in today. We've got Gary Booth with us. We've got Ben Capps with us.
Yeah, man.
Gary, good bit of sparring there with Ben. I mean, I've noticed since I even started coming down here the improvements you know, Ben's been making with you.
Yeah, he's coming on the street. He's working hard in the gym. He's never get him out of the gym, which is a... It's ideal for myself, and yeah, no, he's he boxes to book basically, and he's a great trial, you know, for saying that, you know, if you do something in the gym, keep working on it, and he'll try and express himself through the sparring, doing it, and you know, it's obviously about timing and whatnot, so he just keeps cracking on, and you got to keep going, until you perfect the skill.
Yeah.
Regarding to you know, obviously the sparring type of thing, and the technique side of things. So.
Yeah, I mean, it was hard getting you out of the ring, wasn't it? Gary was trying to get you out of the ring, take a break, but you don't like taking breaks, do you?
Nah, that's it, man. Like, I don't know. You put the work in, you get the results in it. So like, you find out what you're made of in there and all that. You know what I mean? You get a couple kids. They'll spar two rounds, three rounds, and they're tired. They don't want to do it anymore. Like, I like that, you know what I mean? Pushing and finding how far you can push yourself and seeing how far, you know what I mean, you really want it. Because at the end of the day, if you don't want it in sparring, you get found out on the night and you get banged out in front of 20,000 people. I'd rather get found out in there, innit?
Yeah.
The thing is, he's just done six rounds. I mean,
seven.
All right. You know, nightmare. Right. So he's 5 weeks out, and you know, you get tired after four or five, you know what I mean? So, and he needed a bit of rest, so I just pulled the plug. Mm. I might have upset a few people, but at the end of the day, I'm the captain of the ship, you know what I mean? He's, the six rounds would suffice enough, but the seven, and obviously, was a little bit too much because. It was a good spar. It was a good dynamic spar. It wasn't like a touch and warm up first round, second round, blah blah blah. You know what I mean? It was like a bang at it in six rounds. You know what I mean?
Fair enough. Let's talk about your last fight because it was a disappointing night, Middleton Arena. You know, your opponent broke his thumb very early into the fight. Yeah. I mean, we barely had a minute, I think.
90 seconds.
Yeah, and I know you're a slow starter as well, so we didn't really even I know what you can do, right? We didn't even get to see anything of what you can do.
Didn't get to see nothing. Like, it's the most devastating, depressing, disappointing fight I've ever had in my life. and I won it as well. Like, I didn't even get banged out. Like, it's just one of them things, isn't it? Hard shoulders, hard head, weak knuckles. I don't know. Depressing.
Are you saying that your concrete head is what led to the broken thumb?
Yeah. Anyone else would have got knocked out. You got a broken hand.
It was a bit of a crying shame, really. But you know, it is what it is, and it's the fight game. You know, you can train for six, seven, 8 weeks, and it's not in your hands that someone breaks the hand or whatever. You know, it's unfortunate.
Yeah.
But you just got to crack on, and you know, he's come from a different type of. A different world from Australia. The boxing side of things over here is completely different. You know, I won't say the rules are different, but there's a lot more to it than he thought. And he, you know, it's a bit of a shock to his system regarding the training. He's just a training freak, so that's good. And he's very adaptable to all the different styles we've been showing him, but. In regards to the boxing side of it, you know, the show side of it, and fighting on the night, and he does the day before weighing and this, that, and the other, it's all different. Mm. But he's getting used to it, I hope.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you've got your chance again. You're out again October the 26th. No, November the 3rd. November the 3rd. Right, let me just do that bit again, I'll edit it. Right, so you've got your chance again. You're out on November the 3rd, I believe, back at Earlham and Cadishead. That's right,
down the road.
Tell us a little bit about this particular show.
So, you know, Gary's doing a show with Steve Wood and VIP Promotions. So, you know what I mean? They've managed to come together, get a show on down at the Leisure Centre. I didn't get a fight on... I was meant to fight there on Gary's last show, but, you know what I mean, things didn't... get worked out, my license didn't come through in time, but you know what I mean, everything's ready now, and fit, ready 5 weeks out. So, you know what I mean? Tickets are getting sold, so I just want to, just can't wait to get in there and put on a show, innit?
Gary, how did this I mean, obviously, I know you go back with Steve for years and years and years, but how did it come about where you thought, you know, we're going to put on a joint show, and is this something that we're going to see more of in the future? Like, what's the situation?
I needed to crack on with things. I mean, there's been a few. We've been, obviously, in life, it's you're getting ups and downs all the time. I'm boxing mad, and I just needed to crack on with things. And like I said, I've been let down with a few little minor issues, and so I went to see Steve Wood. In fact, even 2 years ago when I spoke to Steve, he said, "No problem, we'll lock horns and we'll get a show going. I'll use my boxers and hopefully whatever he's got available, we'll use his." So I went to see him a little while ago, and again, we've organised this show on the 3rd of November, featuring Jay Taylor, Kieran Leonard, Steve Backhouse, and obviously Ben being a Tabalak, the main event. And we're just waiting on confirmation of two more opponents, two more home fighters. So first come, first serve. I put the feelers out. These 4.5 weeks ago, there's plenty of time. Anyway, if you're a professional boxing trainer and your fighters in the gym, and they've been in the gym for 6, 7, 8 weeks, they should be at least half ready with 4 or 5 weeks to go to start moving on. And the moral of the story is, if anyone wants to jump on the show, you can sell a few tickets, we can accommodate you. But like I say, first come, first serve. I've got a few people I'm waiting on.
Okay, so. Right. So if anyone needs to jump on shows, get in contact with Gary. Ben, obviously looking forward to a crystal ball, right? If the night could go exactly how you planned it, let's say that last one let's just write it off. If you could look into a crystal ball for this fight, how is it going to go, you know, in your ideal world?
6 rounds in the bank, 6 excellent rounds, win every round. Showcase, you know what I'm about, because I'm not here to fuck spiders.
Got it.
So that's it. Like, I just want to get out there and show. Like, I've been here since February, and you know what I mean. Like Gaz said, it's the fight game. Little things happen. Didn't get this show. That show didn't come off. This, that, rah rah. So you know what I mean. We're 5 weeks out, and I just want to get in there and build on that. You know what I mean. And just keep building and building. And just get up there and get out and just start fighting. You know what I mean? Just get in there and then get up. I've been in the gym since February, you know what I mean? And I've had 90 seconds in the ring.
What he doesn't understand is we have a season in boxing, right? That means there's a cut-off date and there's a starting date.
Yeah, I understand that.
So he's come over at a particular time where it's the end of this, it was just before the end of the season. So we had a show booked just before the end of the season, and unfortunately he couldn't get on the show. So he's down in the dumps, obviously, due to
licenses
and stuff like that. So obviously Pat Barrett, I phoned Pat up and he said, "Oh, we can get him on the show." So bang, great. So Pat's put a show on in the middle of the non-season. You with me? He's put a couple on, and he's I respect him for that, because you got some balls to do that, man. Everyone's away on holiday. You know what I mean? The kids are off school. All the parents are minding the kids. Blah blah. It's the same as the gym. It all go everywhere. It goes quiet. So it's good. He's gone on the show, and the fight's been stopped prematurely, and he's banging his head against the wall. When am I going to get out? I've been offered a fight for him already. I've been offered a big fight for him already. And the answer's no. You hear me? Because he's not ready. For me, he's not ready. He needs to adapt to do certain things in the gym. You know what I mean? Listen, if I said to him, bang, he'd go.
Oh yeah, he'd go.
He'd go.
Yeah. But you go now, look at him, he's ready to go.
I want him 3 or 4 fights in, and then we can pop his armbands. Then we'll have a go. You hear me? With these big names and all that. So, you know, slowly, and like I say, in Australia it's all different. Over this side of the world, you know, obviously we've got the season. Now the season's going. Canal, everyone's having shows now. All of a sudden, we booked a show, and all the fighters what I asked for are on other shows. Bum Bum Bump, bigger show, Eddie Earn shows, Frank Warren shows, all that. So we've not gone for small names. We've gone for big names. Obviously, with a big setup, you know what I mean. Yeah. Think big, act big.
That's it, man. All right, well, 3rd of November, looking forward to it. I know you're ready to go now, but, yeah, you know, let's have it 3rd of November.
Wait till then.
You get the final word, Ben. Go on, anything you want to say to people. Why should they come out, see you fight?
Because I'm not here to fuck spiders.
Yeah, man.
It's a Aussie thing. Right. It's the best saying ever. I just had to drop it in.
Can I just mention?
Yeah, go on.
On the 3rd of November, starting at 2 p.m, we're having a skill show for our amateur boxers, okay? And there's going to be about between 16 and 18 kids boxing. There's no winners, there's no losers. But I'd like you all to come out and support the kids, all the local people in Earlham and Cadishead. It'd be really nice. And the kids are boxing in a professional setup, so hopefully with a bit of luck, we're going to change their lives and inspire them to become something. Listen, they might not want to, they might not end up boxing, they might do something else, but what a great feeling. They've seen it on TV, they've seen it on British Boxing TV.
You know.
Yeah, man.
They've seen it on VIP.
You know. We yeah. like them too, don't we? It's all good.
Yeah, man. So the kids are going to aspire to all that, and then they're going to give me a cut off time, and then the pros are going to start. We're going to start the show at 8 p.m, £30. Ringside tickets are £50. There's a bar. This food available, there's going to be top music, believe you me. Our kid's a DJ, and he's up the wall. No raving crap and all Motown, yeah. All Lovers yeah. Rock and all that, and all the sweet stuff, all the old school gear.
Yeah.
Yeah, the gaff will be rocking, UB40, all that gear.
Yeah, oh yeah, I like UB40.
Yeah, so, yeah. And then, it's going to be a fantastic event. And I'm looking forward to it.
And are the drinks going to be reasonably priced?
The drinks are going to be reasonably priced. I've got Ben's dad helping me out with the bar and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So we've got a good quality security company on board, and I don't want to start begging, but go to the pictures with your missus, have a snack to eat, and have a drink. See how much you come home with out of a wanna. You'd be ill. Yeah, come to our boxing event. It's £30 out of ring. You can have a nice drink with the missus. There's £60. There's a score on the finger. You save £20. Live entertainment.
Yeah.
Music, top music. But a professional boxing event. So,
I'm glad you mentioned the boxing at some point.
Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado.
All right. Well, I'm sold. Looking forward to it. 3rd of November, boys. Appreciate your time. Aki Kareem, you know the score. British boxers.
Yeah, man.
Power.
Thanks for coming over, Aki.